So in this video, we're going to review synthetic substitution, but it's also division. So the thing is, we're going to divide x to the fourth minus 3x to the third plus 2x minus 3 by x plus 2. The first thing you do is you rewrite with any missing terms included, so it's 0x squared. Then you bring down the coefficients again. And then you write your negative 2. Since you're dividing by x plus 2, you need to input negative 2 over here. So it's the same thing as synthetic substitution with negative 2 as the input, but it's also synthetic division, so we're dividing the polynomial by x plus 2. Then we'll bring down the 1, multiply, then put the result diagonally to the right, add vertically, multiply again, put that result diagonally and up to the right, add vertically, multiply again, negative 2 times 10, that result, add vertically, multiply one more time, negative 2 times negative 18, you get 36, then you add vertically, and you get 33. Now in this case, you have the output of the function, but it's also the remainder of the division. So when we divide this polynomial by x plus 2, what we're really saying is we get a remainder of 33 right here. And also, here's how you write it. Your results down here of 1, negative 5, 10, negative 18, 33, these all correspond to terms in the polynomial. So this is the quotient polynomial. So we have 1x to the third, negative 5x squared, 10x, and negative 18. And we also have the remainder of 33. So here's how you write it. Here's your quotient and remainder. X to the third minus 5x squared plus 10x minus 18 plus, and then 33 over x plus 2, that's the fraction of the remainder. Remember, with the remainder, you take that remaining part and then divide it by your divisor here, the x plus 2. Okay, so look one more time. Notice how we started with an x to the fourth and we divided by x plus 2, so the first term, or the leading term, should be to the third power, because when we're dividing by x, we're actually subtracting one power of x. So that's why it starts x to the third, x squared, x, 1, and then a remainder here. Okay, and so when you're writing your final quotient and remainder, you want to think about that. What was your degree when you started? What did you divide by? So what should the new degree be? And that should make sense. You're dividing by x plus 2, so instead of x to the fourth, you have x to the third. Okay, so that is a review of synthetic substitution, which is also the same as synthetic division.